रजपुञ्च विचर्चिताय कृतस्मराय विकृतस्मराय नमः शिवाय च नमः शिवाय चलत् क्वणत् कङ्कण नूपुराय
Good afternoon, everybody. Thank you for having me here. Waves of change. What a beautiful subject. Whenever we think about change, we always think about something new, new creative ideas, always. But sometimes, at least for a classical dancer like me, the easiest and most effective way of change can be going back to your roots. I'll tell you how. I was born and brought up in a very small town called Belgaum, the northern part of Karnataka. When I was 5 years old, my mother used to teach me something in the name of Bharatanatyam, because there are absolutely no classical dance teachers in and around northern part of Karnataka. It's the same place, Belgaum, where the Congress session was held in 1924, and the only session where Mahatma Gandhiji was the president. It used to be known as Venugram many centuries ago. Venu means bamboo or even flute, the village of flute. It was under the rule of Hoysalas, Vijayanagara Empire, Bahamanis, and so on. Legends say that there were 108 beautiful Jain temples in and around the fort area of Belgaum. Today we have only two. My entire childhood I spent around these beautiful temples. Here, if one observes carefully, the postures of these beautiful sculptures, they have a very beautiful pattern to it. Exactly how it is mentioned in the ancient book of Natya Shastra and Abhinaya Darpana. So such historically and culturally rich city did not have even one dance teacher in the late 80s to teach me dance. But the change was brought when a great guru came all the way from Mysore and settled down in Belgaum. Today we have more than 35 dance teachers and about 20,000 students learning Bharatanatyam in and around Belgaum. You all might wonder, what is such a great achievement about dance classes? Here I'm not talking about dance classes where students or kids go and learn steps just for the sake of reality shows. I'm talking about a whole education system, parallel education system, which I went through. Today, whatever I am, it's only because of the training that I went through under my guru as a dance student. Whatever I learned in school, that also came along. But the practical implementation of these ideas were possible only through dance. I could be creative, I could be myself, and I can feel that freedom through classical dance. Today I'm a free man. Well, I can say that I came alone from Bangalore. My wife did not come with me. The third, the first part of 2000, when I grew up, I came to Bangalore and took up dance as my career. Here, when we talk about the art form and the artist, we always see there are certain doubts and questions being asked by own people. Why dance? Why music? Why classical dance? Why classical music when there is Bollywood already for entertainment? That is a sad state of our country today, which held our heritage so high just few centuries ago. Today, it's making fun of its own culture. While the foreigners are flowing to India to learn our art form. Sexuality of a man, of a dancer, male dancer, has always been and has been only important point of humor in our Bollywood movies, isn't it? Don't you agree with me? When was the last movie made on the life of classical dancer, intelligent movie made to show how much these classical dancers are enriching the art form, enriching the name of the country abroad? They're traveling every single month, performing right in front of foreign audience. I don't think it has ever happened. This has to change. There is a famous saying in English that dance and music can flourish only when there is peace. But there is a better statement in Sanskrit, which also talks why Natya Shastra was written. To bring the peace and happiness in the society, one must follow traditional art forms. Imagine if I was, as an artist, if I was the president of America, would I ever build a wall? I don't think so. I would have never said, build a wall. I would have said, break it and let all human beings live together happily. That is what I would have said. These are all, we are all artists. That one thing we must understand. At some certain point, we stop being artists. We lose the heart of an artist. I just hope soon the art, the classical art forms, traditional art forms, take the mainstream education system, because, not because it is entertaining, but it creates better human beings for the society. I conclude my performance with another piece, Abhinaya piece. Here I'm showing three characters and a small story where Lord Hanuman, who is a small kid right now, who goes to Kailasham to see Lord Shiva and tells him, I have to see Lord Rama right now. I can't wait. Then Lord Shiva changes his form into a Madari, a monkey charmer, and Anjaneya, Maruti, changes his form to the monkey. Then they go to Ayodhya. Then while seeing his pranks, Hanuman's pranks, Lord Rama, Prince Rama, who is a young boy, asks his servants to bring the monkey, without knowing it is Hanuman, to him so that he can play with him. Later, Rama realizes the power of Hanuman, and many years later, Hanuman and Rama meet, and Rama and Lakshmana are carried on the shoulders of Anjaneya. I'm presenting a very small piece. This is part of a piece called Varanam on Anjaneya. The music has been done by Karthik Hebbar. Thank you.
பராத்பரம் ராமபாத சேவா துரந்தர பவமானநந்தனம் பராத்பரம் ராமபாத சேவா ஆ
Jai Shri Ram, Jai Shri Ram.